Greetings, friends. David Marks here. It's time for our annual Adobe Lightroom Classic upgrade. And this year, we are moving from version 13 to version 14. The good news is that Adobe has made the upgrade process much less complicated this year. Bad news for some Mac users is that this release requires OS X 13 or higher. If you're using something older than OS X 13, then you will need to upgrade your computer's operating system before you can install Classic version 14. With that little warning out of the way, let me walk you through the upgrade process. The first step is that you should make a complete backup before you begin the Lightroom Classic upgrade process. Back everything up. Back up your Lightroom catalog, back up all your photos, back up your whole darn computer. Now, I took care of this step before I started recording this tutorial, so I'm going to move right along, but I urge you, back everything up before you proceed. At this point, some of you might see a message up here from Adobe telling you that a new version of Lightroom Classic is available. If no message appears, then you can come here in the Adobe Creative Cloud App Manager to the Apps section, tap on the three little dots here, and use the Check for Updates button. If your operating system allows, then you should see an option here to update Lightroom Classic. Once you've installed the update and tried to open Lightroom Classic, you should find a dialog like this. This box is trying to tell you that to use Lightroom Classic version 14, your old Lightroom catalog must also be upgraded. After almost 15 years, we've come to expect that part, but what's new is that this time, Classic is going to upgrade your catalog without changing its name. For the first time, whatever your Lightroom catalog is currently named, that's going to be the same name that it will have after the upgrade process completes. That's a big improvement, but there is one other thing to note here. It's worth knowing that Lightroom catalogs are not backwards compatible. In plain English, this means that your new Lightroom Classic version 14 catalog will not work with version 13 or anything older. For most users, this has never mattered. But once in a blue moon, there are Classic users who wish they could downgrade to an older version. I think that the odds that you will never need to downgrade are tiny, but I appreciate that Adobe is finally trying to help us with this process. Since there are no changes needed here, I'm going to tap on the upgrade button. Depending upon the size of your catalog, this might take a little while. Once the catalog upgrade process has finished, we are almost all set. If I were you, I would take this opportunity to do two more things. First is optional, and the second is highly recommended. First, let's talk about the name of your Lightroom catalog. As you can see here, my catalog is named David's Demo Catalog -V13. That V13 tag, that made sense a few minutes ago, but it doesn't make any sense now. To be clear, I don't have to get rid of the V13 part, but it's confusing now, and it's going to be even more confusing, I fear, a year or two down the road when I'm running Classic 15 or 16. Now, finally, Adobe has made fixing this potential annoyance easy too. If I close this window, and if I go to the File, Rename Catalog command, then there's a new way to fix this problem. Using this new dialog box, I can tell Classic what I want my catalog and all of its helper files to be named. So here, I can take out the V13 part. If needed, I can also enable this switch and tell the program that I also want it to rename the folder that contains this Lightroom catalog. If you're playing along, please stop for a second and think about what I'm doing here before you press any of these buttons. First, if you're already happy with the name of your Lightroom catalog, then you do not need to use this new tool. Likewise, if you use a shortcut on a Mac or an alias on a PC to launch your Lightroom catalog, then changing the name of the catalog will break your alias. I'll show you how to replace a broken shortcut or alias in a second, but please think carefully before you go renaming your catalog. Anyway, I'm ready to get rid of the V13 suffix, so I'm going to proceed with these rename changes. This will force Lightroom to relaunch. I'll get a new message that it has indeed been renamed, and you can see that right up here, or you can see that right here. Now, if you just renamed your catalog, and if your alias or shortcut is now broken, then you can quit out of Lightroom. You can trash whatever alias or shortcut you might have had that will no longer work. You can go to the folder that contains your Lightroom catalog. You can find the LRCAT file on a Mac or a PC, the one that has your catalog's name, .lrcat. With a right click, you can create a new alias on a Mac or a shortcut on a PC. Take that new shortcut or alias, if it's helpful, put it out there on your desktop. You can also pin this to the dock or the quick launch bar, if that's helpful. Anyway, the final step, once everything has been upgraded, is to open up Lightroom Classic's Preferences menu. PC folks, you'll find that under the word Edit. Here, let's go to the General tab, and let's go to the Default Catalog option. Click here, and just take a second to make sure that your new catalog, whatever it's called, is indeed the startup default. If it isn't, please fix that at this point. When it looks good in here, PC folks, you can hit save. Mac folks, we can hit quit. The last thing that I recommend is that you make another backup. In my case, I'm going to go catalog settings, backup, when next Lightroom exits. I'll close this window. I'll quit out of Lightroom. I'll go ahead and say backup. And then I'm going to use more sophisticated software like Time Machine on a Mac, or Carbon Copy Cloner, or the Windows File History utility to make a complete backup of everything. I urge you to take this opportunity to back everything up all over again. Personally, I've not seen any horrible bugs while beta testing this version of Lightroom. But if it turns out there is something terrible, some problem lurking beneath the surface, or if some disaster completely unrelated to Lightroom occurs in the near future, then you'll be glad that you have this fresh backup. Well, there you go. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you learned something today, then please leave us a like or a comment down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.